Following the violence and chaos in the Loop last weekend, Chicago police are taking steps to ensure that it doesn't happen again. They've announced additional security measures this weekend that include a curfew for minors in Millennium Park and bag checks at entrances to beaches. Alderman Brian Hopkins, whose second ward includes Streeterville and the Gold Coast, says the mayhem downtown is embarrassing for Chicago on the world stage.
It hurts our reputation, it hurts our image internationally, it affects tourism, it affects potential convention business. You know, there's a lot of concern about what's going to happen during the Democratic National Convention, and fortunately we have time to prepare for that. But it's an embarrassing situation to have Chicago be discussed.
Hopkins says he understands people's reluctance to talk about solutions when, in his words, everything the city has tried so far has failed. Police in South Suburban Dalton shoot and kill a man this morning.
The shooting happened after a woman called police in reference to a man who she had an order of protection against. Police say they found an armed man in a car along the 600 block of 144th Place, just east of MLK Drive. The police department says officers shot the man after making several attempts to get him to drop or surrender the weapon, which was recovered at the scene. Illinois State Police are now investigating. Carolina Garibay, 105.9 WBBM.
The city of Chicago continues to scale back its program to vaccinate people against COVID in their home. 2 years after it launched Protect Chicago at Home, the Chicago Department of Public Health has announced it will only be offered on the weekends. Starting next week, residents will choose from Saturday or Sunday to schedule appointments. You can register for free visits between 8 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. online or over the phone. The city last revised the schedule in February to 3 days a week. The CDC says all of the state is at low COVID community level except for Kankakee and Iroquois counties, which are at medium level. Nancy Hardy, 105.9 WBBM. Former mayoral candidate Paul Vallis has filed a lawsuit accusing a consultant of defrauding his campaign out of hundreds of thousands of dollars. The suit alleges that Chima Obi Inya falsely claimed the money was spent on get-out-the-vote efforts in black communities where Vallis ultimately lost. Inya was allegedly unable to account for nearly $700,000, and the Vallis campaign is now pushing to recoup that money. Inya is the brother of Amara Inya, who ran her own failed campaign for mayor in 2019. A reminder, when you want to listen to WBBM on your phone, download the free Odyssey app and click the word follow for easy access. Or when you're home, just ask your smart speaker to play WBBM News Radio. It's 11:08, traffic and weather together on the 8th with our first check this hour of our roads. We say good evening to Jennifer Thompson.
Good evening. The evening is clear on both sides. Kennedy inbound, heavy from Foster to Lawrence, and then Fullerton to Ogden, about a half an hour ride all here to downtown. The outbound side is tight from the Ohio Street Feeder to Diversey. The Eisenhower and Stevenson are both clear. The Dan Ryan, no problems right now to report. I-57 inbound, no problems. Outbound, 119, 227th. The two right lanes are closed until 9 a.m. The Bishop Ford inbound, northbound 394 before Glenwood Dyer Road. There is road work scheduled in the left lane until about 9 a.m. The outbound side is clear. DeSalvo Lakeshore Drive northbound, it's heavy from Chicago Avenue to Irving Park Road. That is due to road work. As of 8 p.m. tonight, traffic is reduced to one lane between LaSalle and Irving Park Road. The southbound side is clear. The Tri-State, no problems report. The Jane Addams and Ronald Reagan looking pretty good. Northwest Indiana right now, not too bad, but I do want to mention I-80 eastbound. It's Low Pass Ridge Road to Manuka. In Manuka, due to road work in the left lane, and westbound, it's heavy from Briggs to pass the Plains River Bridge. Next traffic report, 11:18.
Clouds and sun going up to 55, and Tuesday about the same, high of 53, and Wednesday sun
shadow. Those like prisons more closely resemble death camps than places where human beings live.
You wouldn't even give your dog this kind of water.
They say bottled water is either too expensive or unavailable, and prison staff members always drink bottled water. Attorney Alan Mills with the Uptown People's Law Center.
Not a new problem. This is the result of decades of neglect in our prison system.
He says the state completed a study of the water issues and has refused to release the results. The activists are demanding prisons over 100 years old like Stateville be closed, and they say if they can't fix the water issues, get prisoners out of harm's way. That's the story from the West Loop.
Illinois U.S. Senator Dick Durbin has announced $500,000 in federal funding for Big Brothers Big Sisters of Metropolitan Chicago. The organization's CEO, Jeremy Foster, says the money will help the organization expand youth mentorship opportunities on the south and west sides of Chicago.
We're excited with the community investment that Senator Durbin was able to secure for Big Brothers Big Sisters of Metro Chicago, which is going to help us impact thousands of children here on the south and west sides of Chicago.
Durbin says the ultimate goal is to increase the number of children served each year to about 5,000 of the 2,000 kids who are currently in the program. An event held in the Weston Suburbs today for organ and tissue donors and their families. Dozens gathered to light candles and watch the raising of the Gift of Hope flag. Kimberly Johnson of Chicago received a kidney and says organ donation is the gift of life.
It is. Let me tell you, if it wasn't for this second chance of life, I wouldn't be here. And I'm so grateful because someone checked the box.
April is Donate Life Month. As of December of 2021, more than 100,000 people in the United States are on the waiting list for life-saving organ, including nearly 4,000 here in Illinois. The AccuWeather extended forecast and the latest in sports news on the way. It's 11:14. Everybody ought to hear from eBay Motors here. Okay, easy now. You're teaching a kid how to parallel park. Turns out, place it for my vehicle. Don't worry, eBay Motors has bumpers, trunk lids, license plate holders, and headlights. And the lots of headlights. You need parts, get it right the first time with eBay Guaranteed Fit. When you see the check, you know that part.
Exceptional outing, allowing one hit over 72. franchise's first title back in 2019. With sports at 16 and 46, Judson Richards, News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
It's 11:18. Traffic and weather together on the 8s. Here's Jennifer Thompson with an update of our road activity. Jennifer?
Right now, the Kennedy inbound is heavy from Armitage to about Ogden. About a 29-minute ride from O'Hare to the Chamber interchange. The outbound side is also heavy from Armitage to Diversity. The Eisenhower and the Stevenson right now, they're both heavy. The Dan Ryan, 12 minutes in, 12 minutes out. I-57 in, no problem. Outbound, 119 to 127. There, the two right lanes are closed until 9 a.m. The Bishop Ford in, northbound 394 before Glenwood Dyer Road. There is road work scheduled in the left lane until 9 a.m. The outbound side is clear. The Southern Lakeshore Drive northbound, it is heavy. From Chicago Avenue to Irving Park Road, that's due to road work. As of 8 p.m. tonight, traffic has been reduced to one lane between LaSalle and Irving Park Road. The southbound side is clear. The Tri-State, Jane Adams, and Ronald Reagan, no problems for report. Northwest Indiana looking pretty good. Next traffic report, 11:28. News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
Thanks, Jennifer. Tonight, partly to mostly cloudy, a low of 40, and tomorrow, breezy, colder, brisk, with a shower or two. Some wet snowflakes are possible, a high of 48 only. Tomorrow night, some clouds and chilly, a low of 35, and Sunday, mostly cloudy, brisk, and not the same as tomorrow, a high of 48. Monday, intervals of clouds and sun going up to 55, and 53 will be the high on Tuesday. Wednesday, some clouds, sun, cool breeze, a high of 53. It's 47 and over here, 50 at midway in the lakefront under mostly cloudy skies. It's 11:20. Our top story this hour, the Supreme Court has preserved a woman's access to a drug used in the most common method of abortion, rejecting lower court restrictions while a lawsuit continues. We'll have much more on this story coming up at 11:31. DuSable Lakeshore Drive will remain open for the foreseeable future, despite a social media hoax that claimed otherwise.
Three Twitter accounts made up to look like the official accounts in Mayor Lori Lightfoot's office, the Illinois Department of Transportation, and the Chicago Department of Transportation all announced that DuSable Lakeshore Drive would be closed to vehicular traffic starting on May 1st. All three accounts have since been suspended. A spokesperson for the mayor's office and IDOT say they're working with Twitter to resolve the matter. The bogus announcement comes one day after Twitter removed verification badges from most official accounts, giving the blue check mark instead to users who pay a monthly subscription fee. The city and state are also in the process of taking public comment on an upcoming renovation of North Lakeshore Drive, and the bogus tweets were accompanied by comments from bicycle and transit advocates who say the drive should be shut down and demolished. Rob Hart, 105.9 WBBM.
A Chicago woman has been named as one of Time Magazine's 100 most influential people in the world. Tracy Hall is the executive director of the American Library Association. She said she was shocked and thrilled to make the list.
I felt elated, and that was what I felt for the
for your big delay is northbound heavy from Chicago Avenue to Irving Park Road due to road work. As of 8 p.m. tonight, traffic is reduced to one lane between LaSalle and Irving Park Road. That's traffic report at 11:38, News Radio 105.9 WBBM. Thank you, Jennifer.
Tonight, partly to mostly cloudy at low of 40. Tomorrow, breezy, colder, brisk with a shower or two. And we could see some wet snowflakes, a high of only 48 tomorrow. Tomorrow night, some clouds and chilly, a low of 35. Sunday, mostly cloudy, brisk and chilly, a high of 48 again. And Monday, intervals of clouds and sun going up to 55 degrees. And Tuesday, our high will be about 53. And about the same on Wednesday. It's 47 degrees at O'Hare, 50 at Midway and the Lakefront. News headlines on the way. It's 11:29.
Join us at Odyssey as we all do our one thing, together millions of things, as we count down to Earth Day. Just one day to go. Reduce junk mail by opting out of pre-screened credit card offers. This can be done online or via phone with the major credit bureaus. Opting out of offers reduces a lot of paper waste and makes getting your mail less of a hassle. When we each share our one thing, it becomes 100 things, 1,000 things, 1,000,000 things for our planet. What's your one thing?
It's another 30.
Chicago's News Traffic and Weather Station, News Radio 105.9 and WBBM NewsRadio.com.
Good evening, I'm Erin Black, and these are our top stories on News Radio WBBM. The Supreme Court continues to allow access to a commonly used abortion drug.
This is Nancy Hardy. There could be a lot more counting tables at nap time as state lawmakers weigh whether to require school districts offer full-day care.
This is Carolina Garibay. An Indiana woman has been charged with a hate crime in the stabbing of an Indiana University student. In WBBM Sports, the Cubs hammer the Dodgers 13-0 at Wrigley, and the Sox blow a ninth-inning lead, falling to the Rays 8-7 in Tampa. Tonight, partly to mostly cloudy, low 40. Tomorrow, cool, breezy, brisk with a shower or two and some wet snowflakes possible, a high of 48 degrees. It's 47 in Chicago right now at 11:31. The Supreme Court has preserved access to a common abortion pill for now, rejecting lower court restrictions on the drug mifepristone. While the lawsuit continues, the court had a self-imposed deadline at midnight tonight to make a ruling. Earlier today, anti-abortion demonstrators gathered outside the court to make their case.
Abortion does not empower women. It never has. It does not make them more successful.
The drug mifepristone has repeatedly been found to be safe and effective and has been used by more than 5 million women in the U.S. since the FDA approved it in 2000. Illinois public schools may soon be required to offer full-day kindergarten. WBBM's Nancy Hardy reports state senators will discuss a bill on the subject next week.
State Representative Mary Beth Canty frames the move from offering half-day to full-day kindergarten in part as an economic issue. The Arlington Heights Democratic sponsor tells Chalk Beat it will help working parents. The news site reports 700 out of the 852 school districts in the state already have full-day kindergarten, but that could include half-day classes plus services. A Downers Grove superintendent says without more funding, some districts won't be able to pay for it, especially during a teacher shortage. The state does not require kids attend school until they turn 6. Nancy Hardy, 105.9 WBBM.
Police said today that an Indiana woman has been charged a second time in the attack of a teenage student earlier this year. WBBM's Carolina Garibay reports.
56-year-old Billy Davis had already been charged with attempted murder and aggravated battery. Officials say she's now also been charged with a federal hate crime. Prosecutors say in January, Davis stabbed an 18-year-old Indiana University student in the head on a public bus. According to court documents, Davis says she stabbed the student, who is of Chinese descent, because of her race. Police say the student, who has not been publicly identified, survived the attack. Carolina Garibay, 105.9 WBBM.
168 years ago today, the streets of downtown Chicago were full of angry residents in what became known as the Lager Beer Riot. Lager historian Richard Lindbergh says the riot was about a clash of culture.
It was really the Protestant and Anglos versus the ethnic Germans, Irish, and other European tribes who favored liberality.
from WWJ's John Hewitt.
The request from the Attorney General came 1 week ago in writing at today's Board of Trustees meeting. Chair Reba Vassar, who had previously publicly supported the release of the documents, said the university would not comply.
And she was told also
Memorial.
mostly cloudy for tonight. We'll have a 40 then for tomorrow. Mostly cloudy, breezy, and chillier. A couple of showers around, even some wet snowflakes could mix in. 948, chilly tomorrow night, down to 35. Brisket chilly Sunday, mostly cloudy. The high is 48. I'm back here with a meteorologist, John Pierre.
Currently it's 47 at O'Hare 49 in Midway 50 at the lakefront under mostly cloudy skies. It's 1140. Another child has been caught in the crossfire, this time in Connecticut.
Authorities in Connecticut's capital say a 12-year-old bystander was killed and three other people wounded in a drive-by shooting. Hartford police say the shooter or shooters appeared to target three males who were standing on a sidewalk Thursday night. Erin Boyce Bird is a lieutenant with the Hartford Police Department.
She was in a parked vehicle. There was three other males on the sidewalk that were dead. So very tragic, very unfortunate.
The 12-year-old girl was shot in the head as she sat in a parked car. No arrests have been made. Jim Crystal, the CBS News.
What is arguably the worst kind of gun violence is way up this year.
The U.S. is setting a record pace for mass killings this year. 17 mass killings since the beginning of the year have taken 88 lives. And each time the killers used firearms, children at a grade school in Nashville were gunned down. Farm workers in Northern California.
Immaculate condition for all night.
crash involving a fuel truck started the fire. It happened on Interstate 95. Now, video of the aftermath of the crash went viral on social media. The cause remains under investigation. Former pro wrestler Ted DiBiase Jr. has been charged with a Mississippi welfare fraud case. DiBiase is accused of receiving sham contracts and misspending millions of dollars that was supposed to help the neediest Mississippi residents. It's the latest development in a widespread corruption case involving a number of wealthy and well-connected people in the state. DiBiase is the son of wrestling legend Ted DiBiase Sr., also known as the Million Dollar Man. 11:46, time now for WBPN Sports. The White Sox entered the bottom of the ninth inning with a two-run lead over the Rays in Tampa, and they left the inning with an 8-7 loss. Ronaldo Lopez allowed a pair of home runs, the last of which a walk-off homer to Brandon Lowe. And the Cubs had a much better day, much better luck, as they hosted the Dodgers at Wrigley Field. With that and the rest of the day in sport, here's Jensen Richards.
We'll begin the friendly confines. Cubs starter Drew Smiley took a perfect game into the eighth inning, but an infield hit by the Dodgers, David Peralta, allowed him to reach base. So no perfect game for Smiley, but a stellar outing nonetheless, allowing just one hit over 7 2/3 innings, striking out 10. Smiley becomes the first Cubs pitcher to be perfect for 7 innings since Jose Guzman back in 1993. As an organization, the Cubs are still looking for their first perfect game. Now, Smiley didn't necessarily need a ton of run support, but boy, did he get it. Including one of the hottest hitters in all of baseball, Patrick Wisdom, now the fifth.
Reed sets up high, kicks, and delivers. High drive into deep left field. Down the line, if it's there, it's gone, and this one is long gone. Cubs have blown the doors open. A three-run home run by Patrick Wisdom. 8-0 Cubs over the Dodgers here in the fifth.
Zach Zimmen on the call, 670 the score. That's Wisdom's ninth of the year, tied for most in baseball at game 10. Cody Bellinger, Trey Mancini, Nico Horner also homered, one of four hits for Horner. Cubs last, the Dodgers 13-0. It's the most lopsided loss the Dodgers have ever suffered at Wrigley. Cubs have scored 10 runs or more in six of their first 19 games. Now to football, four Lions players were among five players league-wide to be suspended for violating the NFL's gambling policy. Lions wide receiver Quintez Cephas and safety C.J. Moore and Washington Commanders defensive end Sean Contone have been suspended indefinitely. Lions former first-round pick Jamison Williams, the wide receiver, and Stanley Berryhill are being suspended for six games each for mobile betting that occurred at the Lions facility. These two did not bet on NFL games. The Lions have since released Cephas and Moore. With sports at 16:46, Judson Richards, News Radio 105.9, WBBM.
11:48, traffic and weather together on the 8th. How are our roads, Jennifer?
Well, the Kennedy is getting a lot better, thank goodness. Right now, we're looking at travel time with about 21 minutes from all year to downtown. Inbound, it's slow from Armitage to Ogden. The outbound side, slow from North Avenue to Diversey. The Eisenhower and the Stevenson are both clear. The Dan Ryan, no problems to report. I-57 and the Bishop Ford are also clear. Just on Lakeshore Drive northbound, it's tight in Chicago Avenue to about Irving Park Road. That's due to road work as of 8 p.m. tonight. Traffic has been reduced to one lane between LaSalle and Irving Park Road. Southbound, it's heavy from 53rd to about 57. The Tri-State, Jane Addams, Ronald Reagan, all looking good. Virtual Memorial is clear. I-80 eastbound, slow past Bridge and Manuka. Due to road work in the left lane, the westbound side heavy from Bridge to past Plains River Bridge. The two right lanes are closed before Richards to pass center from 10 tonight until 5 a.m. Monday. That's due to road work with various ramps closed through the work zone. Follow us on Twitter at WBBM1059 Traffic. Next traffic report, 11:58, News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
Thank you, Jennifer. Tonight, partly to mostly cloudy, a low of 40. Tomorrow, considerable cloudiness, breezy, much colder and brisk with a shower or two, and we could see some wet snowflakes. A high of 48. Tomorrow night, some clouds in Chile, a low of 35. Sunday, mostly cloudy, brisk and chilly, a high of 48 again. And Monday, a little bit warmer, a high of 55. Tuesday, mostly cloudy, still cool, a high of 53, and that will also be the high on Wednesday. It's 47 at O'Hare, 49 at Midway, 50 at the lakefront. It's 11:50.
Chicago's only station dedicated to news around the clock. News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
The probation has been overturned for the operator of a suburban kennel where 29 dogs died in a fire in 2019.
probation for the fire in West Suburban West Chicago, the toughest punishment that DuPage County Judge Robert Miller could hand down. The judge had hoped to keep Mercado from ever having more than one pet until the probation ended in 2027. But now the 3rd District Illinois Appellate Court has overturned that sentence, saying Miller imposed too much time. The most Mercado should have gotten, the court says, was 2 years probation. It's alleged that Mercado kept the dogs in horrible conditions, and they may have had no chance of even escaping the fire. Terry Keschner, 105.9 WBBS.
A new CBS poll finds that two-thirds of Americans feel people need to address climate in the coming years. More than half think action is necessary right now. Details from CBS News Deputy Director of Surveys, Jennifer DePinto.
For a third of Americans, climate change is something that can be dealt with either further in the future or not at all. When we ask why, the top reasons, there are more pressing issues right now and that the effect of climate change is exaggerated. A small majority say there's nothing we can do about climate change. That's a reason that's cited more often by older people. Also, this group does not see an economic benefit in reducing climate change. More think efforts to do that will hurt the economy, not help it.
More Democrats than Republicans see climate change as a priority. Spring cleaning season is here, and sometimes a little music can make it go faster. A new One Bowl finds the top three songs we listen to while we tidy up for the season are Flo Rida, Bon Jovi, and Katy Perry Spears 2. Survey finds more than half of us take part in the annual rite of spring cleaning and organizing. 8 in 10 say it makes them feel more in control of their lives. Deborah Rodriguez, CBS News.
Bloomberg Business with Larry Kofsky just ahead. It's 11:52.
Hey fans, it's Coach Radio play-by-play announcer Pat Hughes.
Find out next at 11.
hop, skip, and a fork away.
Hi, can I take your order?
Join Lake County for Restaurant Week from April 14th to the 23rd. 10 days to savor, 80 restaurants to discover. Grab a friend or four and find a new favorite dish.
And here are the drinks.
There's a world of flavors waiting just around the corner. Visit LakeCountyRestaurantWeek.com. Participate in our check-in challenge and see what restaurants are on the menu.
Great money off to here for eBay Motors. Easy now. You're teaching your kid how to parallel park. Turns out, things are moved by people. Don't worry, eBay Motors has bumpers, trunk lids, license plate holders, and headlights. And a lot of headlights. You need parts, get it right the first time with eBay Guaranteed Fit. When you see the check, you know that part's gonna fit. eBay Motors, let's ride. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Yes, we do have availability this day. We're having a guest.
Andrew's Boutique Hotel is the destination to tie the knot.
Oh, you want the whole property?
She needs an assistant to catch the bookings bouquets.
249, yes. Oh, and three dogs.
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need a date.
Indeed you do. We instantly connect you with quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job description. Visit Indeed.com/creditpick and $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
WPBN Chicago and WCFS-FM and HD1 Elwood Park, Chicago.
Always live on the free Odyssey app.
Hear the latest Illinois lottery numbers. Pick 3, Evening Game, 672, Fireball 3. Pick 4, Evening Game, 1685, Fireball 0. And Lucky Day Lotto, Evening Game, 2, 5, 6, 25, 29. And Mega Millions, 3, 21, 29, 46, 63, Mega Ball, 9. It's 11:58, traffic and weather together on the 8th. Let's get another check of our roads with Jennifer.
The roads are looking pretty good. The big trouble spots right now are mainly just bobbled into drive and the Kennedy. We'll begin with the Kennedy inbound. It's just the lowest slope from North Avenue to Austin. 21 minutes from all here to downtown outbound, a slope from Fullerton to Belmont. And then on to Spobble Lakeshore Drive. Northbound heavy from Chicago Avenue to Irving Park Road due to road work. Southbound heavy from 53rd to 57th. You get traffic and weather together at News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
Thank you, Jennifer. And good night.
It's AccuWeather says tonight partly to mostly cloudy, a low of 40, and tomorrow considerable cloudiness, cold and brisk, a high of 48. It's 11:59.
Featuring the news that matters and breaking news at any time, this is Chicago's news traffic and weather station, News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
Coming up in the next hour on News Radio, another installment of When Radio Was. Here are the top stories on WBBM. In a late Friday night move, the Supreme Court decided to preserve women's access to abortion drug mifepristone. CBS News will have the latest. After last weekend's violence in the Loop, one alderman hopes the city has a better plan for dealing with large groups of young people this weekend. And
this is Brandon Eisen in the West Loop. Some new federal funding will help expand youth mentoring efforts in Chicago.
Sports, the Cubs hammer the Dodgers 13-0 at Wrigley, and the Sox blow a ninth-inning lead, falling to the Rays 8-7. It's 47 in Chicago at midnight. CBS News is next.
CBS News on the hour, presented by Indeed.com.
I'm Tom Foley in Washington, where the U.S. Supreme Court is leaving in place current rules on the distribution of a widely used abortion bill. A federal judge in Texas effectively ordered it off the market. For now, that is not happening. Legal analyst Tate Roosevelt.
The important thing about this ruling is that not only does it place a stay on the Texas trial judge's decision to overturn the approval of the abortion drug, but it places a similar stay on the ruling of the appellate court, which would have prevented the drug from being sent in the mail and required that the drug not be used past 7 weeks of pregnancy, down from the original 10 weeks.
A new prosecution team reverses course on a criminal case against a famous actor charged in the accidental shooting death of a film photographer working with him.
The involuntary manslaughter charge against actor Alec Baldwin was officially dismissed. Still facing charges, however, is the film's weapons supervisor, Hannah Gutierrez-Reed. Shortly after the dismissal filing took place, lawyers on the status hearing online, prosecutor Carrie Morrissey.
Having dismissed the charges currently against Mr. Baldwin, we want to get some guts.
The case against Gutierrez-Reed will proceed. Her trial right now is set for August, and prosecutors have held out the possibility that they could refile charges against Baldwin.
The Florida Culture Awards moved to the street. Students across the country protested the governor's education. pilot Stephen Portnoy.
The president's order describes the right to live in a healthy environment as a matter of justice. It aims for a government-wide effort.
Environmental justice will become the responsibility of every single federal agency. I mean, every single federal agency.
In the Rose Garden, President Biden blasted Republicans for seeking to repeal the climate investments in his Inflation Reduction Act.
Imagine making that choice.
House Speaker Kevin McCarthy says he aims to limit federal spending.
Police in Minnesota have negotiated the surrender of an armed man after shutting down roads near
hire with minimal effort and maximum success with Indeed. Their powerful hiring platform makes it easy to attract, interview, and hire candidates all in one place. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
Champagne's not as cheap as ginger ale, and you can't buy caviar for the same price as candy. But now, you can buy Beautyrest Hybrid in the highest-end Tempur-Pedic mattresses for nowhere near highest-end prices. Hassleless Mattress is clearing out a handful of premium floor models, like the Beautyrest Queen Haven Bay. Was on sale for $1,178, now just $471. Only a few remain, and they will sell out. Find an employee-free Chicagoland showroom near you at Hassleless.com. Join us at Odyssey as we all do our one thing, together millions of things for our planet. Today is Earth Day, and you can celebrate all year round. Make the switch to eco-friendly cleaning products, or make your own from ingredients like castile soap and vinegar. Spend more time outside instead of watching TV, and use electricity, and walk or bike to close destinations. That way, both you and the Earth can celebrate. When we each share one thing, it becomes 100 things, 1,000 things, 1,000,000 things for our planet. What's your one thing? And now, When Radio Was. Brought to you by RadioSpirits.com. Outside the Loyola University Medical Center on First Avenue. Cloudy, brisk and chilly, high again 48. Monday intervals of cloud. dogs in prisons. Activist Tanya Lozano said you wouldn't give the water to your dog.
And the fact that we were here almost a year ago, and a year later we're standing here again asking for decency. These are human beings.
Malia Gertzmo with the National Resources Defense Council.
What we have generally found is a culture of intentional neglect. This is not a matter of a few cells in one building and one prison. The issues run deep, they run wide, and some of them stretch decades back.
She described black water that comes out of taps that makes people sick and that they filter with bed sheets and that makes their skin itch. Attorney Alan Mills with the Uptown People's Law Center says some prisons that are over 100 years old need to be closed. Others need to fix the problems or get the inmates out of them. That's the story from the West Loop.
Governor Pritzker in the last governor's race is reportedly thinking about heading to Washington.
Former Republican candidate for Governor Darren Bailey is reportedly considering running for Congress. The 12th district is currently represented by Republican Mike Boss, so it would be an inter-party battle. Bailey was at former President Trump's Mar-a-Lago resort for a fundraiser for a Louisiana Republican candidate for governor. Politico reports Bailey was able to talk specifically with Trump about the move. Lost has raised more than $400,000 in the past quarter for his re-election. Bailey lost the governor's race 55% to 42%. Cisco Coda 105.9 WBBF.
Not everyone in the cannabis business is hitting the jackpot. Independent craft growers have their money tied up in licenses, which are producing little to no income.
Elizabeth Vargas Paynez of the craft growers trade group. Big leader in to think about the so-called social equity license holders.
For a long time, we've been using that term as a catch-for-all, as opposed to really understanding the operators who are investing their livelihood, their future into this market that has yet to become operational for them. And make no mistake, these licenses aren't going to go anywhere. Social equity operators are going to be forced to sell or lose a lot of their equity, and cannot stand that. We cannot let that happen. That is not the spirit of the industry that we were promised.
The growers say they need relief. The licenses are now worth less than they paid.
The Illinois Capitol, dead dog. Well, 5-9 WBBF. The weather extended forecast and the latest in sports news on the way. It's 15 after the hour.
The Odyssey app.
Easy to get my news right on the app.
I stream it on the app.
At work.
I listen all day at work.
The app is the easiest way to go for me because it's convenient and always there.
Chicago's biggest traffic and weather station. All the Odyssey app now. 105.9 WBBF. Trying again from Classic Drapes and Blinds. Have you been dreaming about new window treatments for your home? Well, now you can stop dreaming and start dialing. Simply pick up the phone and dial 773-CLASSIC for your free in-home estimate. You'll save up to 50% off retail with no interest payments for up to 2 years. You do know it's best to choose your drapes where you use your drapes. At Classic Draperies, we give your windows the treatment they deserve. Now remember, a drapery and blind shop at home, just pick up that phone and dial 773-CLASSIC today. That's 773-CLASSIC. And if you're looking to purchase new drapes and blinds for your home, but you don't know who to call, well, now you can call Classic Draperies. Simply pick up the phone and dial 773-CLASSIC for your free in-home estimate. You can choose from decorative drapes for your living room, romantic room shades for the bedroom, or solar shades for your sunroom. Dial 773-CLASSIC now and save up to 50% off retail, plus up to 2 years of free financing. Now remember, for drapery shop at home, just pick up that phone and dial 773-CLASSIC today. Call now.
It's 16 after the hour. Time now for the AccuWeather 5-day forecast, sponsored by Four Seasons Heating, Air Conditioning, Plumbing, and Electric. Here's meteorologist Carl Levinsky.
Early on this Saturday morning, partly to mostly cloudy and chilly, low 40. Later today, considerable cloudiness, breezy and much chillier with a shower or two. There could even be some wet snowflakes, high 48. Partly cloudy tonight, low 35. Mostly cloudy, brisk and remaining chilly tomorrow, high 48. Monday, with intervals of clouds and sunshine, the high 55. Tuesday, mostly cloudy, remaining cool, high 53. Wednesday, sunshine, patchy clouds, and a cool breeze, high 53. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Carl Budinski.
Time now for the WBBM Sports. The White Sox blew a late lead in Tampa, falling to the Rays 8-7, and Sox reliever Ronaldo Lopez gave up a pair of ninth-inning home runs, including a two-run walk-off to Brandon Lowe. But a much different story on the North side. Judson Richards has that story and the rest of the day in sports.
We'll begin in Wrigley Cup. Second baseman Nico Horner's reached base at an impressive rate to begin the year, but not by way of home run. Until now, we go to the fifth.
Line drive hit
Patrick Wisdom in his ninth of the year. Cody Bellinger and Trey Mancini went back-to-back. All is 13-0 behind a stellar, almost perfect performance by Drew Smyly, who was perfect for 7 innings before an infield single broke it up. Smyly goes 7 2/3 innings, striking out 10, allowing just that one hit. It was all gratitude after the game.
I love you, Nina Cubs. I love pitching here at Wrigley. The atmosphere and the fans are, you can't say enough cool things about it. Like, every single day is such an awesome atmosphere, and it just hypes up this whole team. So, you know, I feel blessed to be part of this organization, and I'm so happy to re-sign here this offseason and to keep playing.
Smyly on the Marquee Sports Network. The Cubs have scored 10 or more runs in 6 of their first 19 games. One note from college football, the NCAA approved a rule change for the upcoming season that will allow the clock to run after first downs in all divisions except Division III. The clock will continue to stop during the final 2 minutes of each half. Coupled with a couple of other rule changes, the goal is to keep the game moving while reducing the number of plays. With sports at 16:46, Judson Richards, News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
It's 18 after the hour. Traffic and weather together on the 8s with our overnight road projects. Here's Neil Fiorito.
On the rails, shuttle buses will replace weekend CTA Blue Line service between Addison and Western to accommodate work to replace the 50-year-old track. Extra time will be needed. On the Kennedy outbound Fullerton to Addison, 2 left lanes closed. Plant work on 55 in Will County southbound before US 52 to Route 59 in the 2 left lanes until 9 a.m. I-57 inbound Moni Manhattan Road to Stunkel, the right lane closed along with various ramps. Outbound on 57 from 119 to 127, scheduled work in the 2 right lanes. Overnight on northbound the Sauble Lakeshore Drive, traffic reduced to 1 lane between LaSalle and Irving Park Road. The ramps will be open on I-80 westbound before Richards to Bass Center. 2 right lanes closed throughout the weekend until Monday morning at 5, with various ramps closed for the work zone. Traffic and weather together, News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
Quick check of our AccuWeather forecast. Later today, considerable cloudiness, breezy, much chillier with a shower or two. Some wet snowflakes could rain down, a high of 48. And tonight, some clouds and chilly, a low of 35. It's 20 after the hour. Our top story, access to the abortion pill has been preserved by the U.S. Supreme Court for now. We'll have much more on this story coming up at 31 after the hour. In other news, calling all thrill seekers, Six Flags Great America is back today for the 2023 season. This year, there won't be any new ride at the park. Instead, Rachel Canziora with Six Flags says the focus has been on enhancing the guest experience.
While that could mean adding a new ride or a new attraction, I think it also means adding completely new experiences for our guests. And this year, our focus is really providing that elevated special event and festival experience.
Some of those new experiences include a Pride celebration in June and Flavors of the World, an event where visitors can try food items from across the world. Canziora says the park itself is also getting some upgrades.
Guests will notice increased seating and shade around the park. We have brand new park benches coming in. Guests can also see refreshed landscaping and lots of renovations around the park. We're renovating a lot of our restaurants and retail locations throughout the park right now.
Six Flags is primarily open on weekends only until May 23rd, when daily admission will begin and will run through the summer. Carolina Garibay, 105.9 WBBM. Time Magazine has named a Chicago woman one of the top 100 most influential people in the world. Tracy Hall is 10th executive director of the American Library Association and the first black woman to run the organization in its nearly 150-year history. Hall says being named to Time's 100 most influential list is an honor and comes at a crucial free speech.
It feels incredible. It's an incredible moment, of course, for libraries. It's not about me, but about the librarians and the libraries across the country.
The list, now in its 20th year, recognizes the impact, innovation, and achievement of the world's most influential individuals. Hall is featured in this month's issue on newsstands and online now. Bloomberg Business just ahead. It's 22 after the hour.
Welcome back to Ask Hassles. I'm Weston. What's your question?
What keeps you up at night?
My box spring.
Your box spring?
Sure. It supports my mattress, prevents sagging, and gives my bed a little elevation. So yeah, my box spring keeps me up at night.
You're a literal guy, aren't you?
Through Monday, you can literally get a free box spring with the purchase of a new Sealy Posturepedic or pre-arrest mattress at Hassle's or take an equal amount off a new adjustable base.
So nothing else keeps you up at night?
Well, I sometimes lay awake wondering why the word abbreviated is so long. Or if the number 2 pencil is most popular, why is it still number 2? Or do fish ever get thirsty?
These questions are going to keep me up at night.
Get a free box spring with your new Beautyrest or Sealy Posturepedic mattress through Monday at Hassle's Mattress. Open 9 to 9. Find a Chicagoland showroom near you at Hassle's.com. Hassle's. Employee free. Guaranteed.
The CEO of Google says hallucination problems still plague artificial intelligence and he doesn't know why. I'm Jeff Goldman of Fortune Magazine with the Fortune Business Update. Google's new chatbot called Bard is part of a revolutionary wave of AI that can rapidly generate anything from an essay on William Shakespeare to rap lyrics in the style of DMX. But Bard, as all its chatbot peers, still have at least one serious problem. They sometimes make stuff up. For example, on 60 Minutes recently, Bard mentioned a book called The Inflation Wars, A Modern History, by Peter Temin, an economist. Temin is real, and he writes books, but he never wrote that one, nor did anyone else. Bard just made up the book. Why? How? Google CEO Sundar Pichai says no one knows, not even AI experts. When asked if the hallucination problem will be solved, he doesn't say yes. He says it's a matter of intense debate. I'm Jeff Goldman.
College graduates will be hitting the job market very soon. Rick Cobb, founder of workplace consulting firm To Discern here in Chicago, joins Rob Hart on the WBBM New Business Hour to discuss what's in store for them and other newer members of the workforce.
What is the job market like for the class of 2023?
Sure. Well, I think the market's still relatively strong, particularly for graduates. So take a look at a couple of things. First of all, graduates have to appreciate this is not the only job you'll ever have. Your first job, more than ever, is not going to be the last job you have. So that first job is about gaining experience and becoming credible to the larger job market for the future. Statistically, it's very likely that you're going to change jobs at least 3 or 4 times over the course of your career. The other part of it is important. We're only, nationally, we're 4.5% unemployment. There's a lot of fun headlines about having huge increases in the number of layoffs. We have. But the original numbers were so small that if they quadrupled, it's not really that big a deal. And in Illinois, every single market sector, except non-farm payroll, every single market sector except for technology is up. Technology is the only one that's down, and it's down marginally. A lot of these layoffs came from really big companies, certainly big technology companies and then other large companies. And net job growth in the United States always happens in the mid-cap and smaller. So there's lots of opportunities out there.
In general, with maybe 5 weeks to go until graduation day, how many college seniors have a job lined up already, and how many are still looking?
I think the majority, I'm speaking for off the cuff, I don't have data for you on that. I think the majority of college seniors that are not in an internship environment are likely to still be looking, except for the STEM background students, which are always going to be able to find something. These entry jobs in STEM now actually make a difference in the organization from the very beginning. So the learning curve for them is not as steep because a lot of the things that they know already are needed immediately. And the cost to hire them is against keeping a senior manager. There's no comparison in terms of the trade-off.
Rick Cobb, founder of the workplace consulting firm To Discern in Chicago.
A reminder, you can catch the New Business Hour each weekday and subscribe to the podcast at Odyssey.com or wherever you get your podcasts. Let's get another quick look at our AccuWeather forecast. Home for a cold weekend. Later today, considerable cloudiness, breezy, much chillier with a shower or two. Some wet snowflakes are possible. A high of 48 degrees and tonight some clouds and chilly. A low of 35. News headlines up next. It's 27 after the hour.
Got the itch for a sports car, exotic or luxury pre-owned vehicle? Don't do luxury and sports will scratch that itch. Over 900 pre-owned vehicles are in stock waiting for you. Convertibles, high performance models, exotics, all with low interest rates. Scratch your itch at Don't Do Luxury and Sports or at GLIGroupview.com.
We can beat them all.
Service to a green
tea. Hi, this is Tonya Khoury of Green Tea Windows. Increase the beauty and value of your home with our exceptional
imposed a 4 p.m. curfew for unaccompanied children in the latest effort to prevent a repeat of last weekend's violent disturbances involving young people in the loop. CBS 2's Suzanne Ligneau reports police law commanders and senior officers were also in the field last night. They'll be taking command of situations. There will be captains, lieutenants, and sergeants. They'll be directing the younger officers who don't necessarily have experience being in the middle of large crowds. Those senior ranking officers will also issue arrest orders if necessary. Potential for repeat is also forcing some other events to be moved. Last night's musical performance by students at Leighton High School, which had been scheduled for 7-8 downtown, was moved to Oak Park River Forest High School as a precaution. Half a century before Prohibition and Al Capone, thousands of immigrants living in Chicago fought with police on this day. Yesterday, in 1855, the Lager Beer Riot was about a clash of cultures.
This is really Chicago's first riot. There have been so many.
Author and historian Richard Lager, German and Irish residents marched down to Chicago's courthouse on Randolph to protest newly elected mayor Clive Newell's move to raise the cost of a liquor license to $300 in attempts to close some of serving alcohol.
Professor of Economics at Virginia Tech expects that the U.S. will see
than 65 light years. We'll have more about the moon and its companions tomorrow. And we have more sky watching tips and much more about the universe at Stardate Magazine. Details at stardate.org. For the University of Texas at Austin McDonald Observatory, I'm Billy Henry.
After years on the road, the owners of a taco stand finally have a place to call their own.
Taylor Mason is the founder and owner of Taylor's Tacos, which opened its first brick-and-mortar location on Taylor Street near Lackland on the Near West Side. She got her start in 2014. Chicago native wanted to bring West Coast tacos to the Midwest.
I went to school in Southern California where I fell in love with the street taco and just the interaction right on the street, hot and juicy in your face.
Taylor's Tacos was a pop-up catering company until the pandemic hit 3 years ago. She tells the New Business Hour it forced her and her wife to become creative.
Because now we offer taco gigs, we do taco bars, we do all these things we wouldn't have done if it wasn't for the we're having to be locked in, you know, and thinking outside of the box.
Taylor's Tacos moved into its first brick-and-mortar location 1 month ago. Rob Flirt, 105.9 WBBM.
Still to come, top trending stories, sports, overnight road projects, and weather. It's 43 after the hour.
In Chicago, spring weather can be tough to predict. Of potential weather that's coming. Rain and some thunder with some severe weather possible. Plan ahead with our 5-day forecast at 15 past the hour. Sponsored by Four Seasons Heating, Air Conditioning, Plumbing, and Electric. For all the right reasons, call 866-4 Seasons.
Because I need to know what to wear.
You're being taken to the lot of it.
Chicago's news, traffic, and weather station.
Gives us a guide to the air.
105.9 WBBM.
Advent founder Dr. Mullen Kandula on Advent's one-stop shop office-based procedures approach to solving breathing triangle problems.
A lot of folks are like, I don't want to get surgery. You know, isn't there something else we can do? And at Advent, there is something else we can do. We have a whole host of office-based options where you don't have to go to surgery. You can do it under local anesthesia. Get these things taken care of. How does that sound? And don't be surprised when you hear that a lot of people go for those options. When given the choice between surgery and office procedures, almost everybody that we talk to, you give them the choice, they choose the office. It's not surprising. That's just understanding your patients and offering them the options that they would choose. So I think at Advent, when you put all that together, we are a one-stop shop for these issues.
Schedule your appointment at AdventNotes.com today, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
About the payroll tax refund for months. I'm so proud that we've helped over 15,000 businesses claim over $5 billion in cash incentives. If you own a business, even if you've asked your CPA about this, you owe it to yourself to take another look. Every client is assigned a licensed and insured tax attorney who evaluates your company at my expense to accurately determine eligibility. Innovation Refunds has hundreds of five-star reviews on Trustpilot and Google, and your business might be entitled to receive up to $26,000 per employee. Businesses of all types can qualify, including medical, professional, construction, even nonprofits. Please don't miss out on this. Even your doctor would tell you to get an expert second opinion, and we do a lot of work for doctors. Download the Innovation Refunds app now, or go to GetRefunds.com to potentially get a payroll tax refund of $26,000 per employee. GetRefunds.com. GetRefunds.com.
It's 45 after the hour.
Top trending stories on WBBM NewsRadio.com.
A businessman has become the first defendant to plead guilty in a federal investigation into payoffs to the head of the Michigan Marijuana Licensing Board. John DeValle appeared in court 2 weeks after reaching a plea deal. DeValle says he provided over $68,000 and private flights to Rick Johnson, who was serving as the head of the licensing board. Johnson and two other defendants in the case are expected to plead guilty next week. Vermont Governor Phil Scott has signed a bill that raises the eligibility age for marriage to 18. Vermont becomes the eighth state in the country to end child marriage. Supporters of the bill say it will reduce domestic violence and unwanted pregnancies. A New Jersey-based group that lobbies to raise the marriage age says between 2000 and 2018, there were nearly 300,000 children married in the United States, with most of those between teenaged girls and adult men. It's 16 after the hour.
Judge, a walk-off homer to Brandon Lowe. The Cubs had a much better day and much better luck as they hosted the Dodgers at Wrigley Field. With that and the rest of the day in sports, here's Judson Richards.
There have been 17 no-hitters in Cubs history, and they've been close, but still never a perfect game. At Wrigley Field, Drew Smyly took a perfect one into the seventh. Works his motion, of course, and back, tapper down the third baseline, picked up by Smyly.
Oh, and he collides with Gomes. Safe at first is Peralta.
That came in 6-7 to score. A broken bat single was what breaks up Smiley's bid for a perfect game, but just an exceptional outing, allowing one hit over 7 2/3 innings while striking out 10. Smyly becomes the first Cubs pitcher to be perfect through 7 innings since Jose Guzman back in 1993. 13 runs in all scored by the Cubs offense. Patrick Wisdom in his ninth of the year, tied for most in baseball at game's end. Cody Bellinger, Trey Mancini, Nico Horner also homered, one of four hits for Horner. Skipper David Ross on the offense.
You know, offensively, I think what stands out about this group early on is just they're not giving away an at-bat. Like, it doesn't matter what the score is. Each guy is having their at-bat and grinding it, and it just, that's what happens. It just keep tacking on.
Cubs bubble the Dodgers 13-0, most lopsided loss the Dodgers have ever suffered at Wrigley. The Cubs have scored 10 runs or more in six games already through their first 19. Now to basketball. Victor Wembanyama, the projected number one overall pick, officially declared for the NBA draft. And the Toronto Raptors fired their head coach, Nick Nurse. Nurse led the Raptors to the franchise's first title back in 2019. With sports at 16-46, Judson Richards, News Radio 105.9.
It's 48 after the hour. Talking weather together on the 8th. Here's Neil Fiorito with our overnight road projects.
Overnight road work scheduled once again on northbound DuSalvo Lakeshore Drive, where they will be down to one lane between LaSalle and Irving Park. The ramps will be open on I-80 westbound before Richards and Bass Center. Two right lanes closed overnight until 5 a.m. on Monday. Also, various ramps to the work zone will be shut down as well. And then on both sides of I-80 between I-55 and Ridge, the left lane closed until 10 a.m. Northwest Indiana, ongoing work in spots on 80-94, especially near I-65. Same deal on 65 near the Borman. And on the toll road in spots through Hammond and Gary. Had to work on the Kennedy outbound, Fullerton to Addison in the two left lanes. Will County, I-55 southbound before U.S. 52 to Route 59. Work in the two left lanes until 9 a.m. On northbound 394, before Glenwood Dyer Road, scheduled work in the left lane until 9 a.m. Traffic and weather together, News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
Let's get another check of our AccuWeather forecast. Early this morning, partly to mostly cloudy, chilly at low 40. Later today, considerable cloudiness, breezy, much chillier with a shower or two. And we might see some wet snow on flakes out there, a high of 48. And tonight, some clouds and chilly, going down to 35. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy, brisk and chilly, a high of 48. A repeat of today, Monday, intervals of clouds and sun, going up to 55. It's 50 after the hour.
Chicago's only station dedicated to news around the clock. News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
More than 40,000 people are expected to today's Cubs game against the Dodgers at Wrigley Field. But we guarantee no one will be as colorfully dressed as Austin Huff. The morning co-host on our sister station, US 99, will be wearing a custom-made blazer, made famous for being worn by the flamboyant head coach of the LSU women's basketball team.
I just can't walk in. Astounding jacket. I what I believe is an ostrich feather lace floral jacket. Very pink, very bright. And I, you know, it's funny. I tweeted, if this tweet gets 5,000 likes, I will find that jacket, buy it, and then wear it to a Cubs game.
Well, he got way more likes than that, and even caught the attention of Mulkey's designer, who's letting him borrow it for free. Coronation keepsakes are all the rage in the UK. CBS's Deborah Rodriguez takes a look. There are official royal jewels galore for sale ahead of King Charles' coronation, but none has come close to the popularity of Queen Elizabeth's Jubilee Barbie. It was out of stock in 3 seconds last summer. There's still some time for her son's memorabilia to catch up. Britain's Center for Retail Research estimates the May 6th coronation will boost consumer spending there by the equivalent of $1.7 billion, thanks to biscuit tin Rodriguez, CBS News. Nearly 300 silver coins, believed to be more than 1,000 years old, have been discovered near a Viking fortress site in northwestern Denmark. A rare trove was unearthed by a young girl who was metal detecting in a cornfield last fall. The trove includes Danish, Arab, and German coins, as well as pieces of jewelry originating in Scotland or Ireland. Just ahead in your next job, tips on the phone screen interview. It's 52 after the hour.
When you hear Spring Black Friday at the Home Depot, and Ryobi 40-volt expanded cordless string trimmers are just $179, what are you driven to do? Clear out winter's overgrowth? Clean up the driveway lines? Or take a lighter touch around the flower beds? Hurry into the Home Depot during Spring Black Friday to get more done with the extended runtime and precision control of the Ryobi 40-volt expanded cordless string trimmer. Now just $179. Shop Spring Black Friday savings at the Home Depot. How doers get more done.
That's your captain. Better buckle your seatbelts for this one. I saw my passport expired, so I went to Staples, got a passport photo, lickety-split. While I was there, I grabbed some tiny travel soap and shampoo. Yeah, feeling fresh as a daisy.
Staples has everything for travel. 10-minute passport photos, luggage, headphones, even personal travel items. And now at Staples, get 40% off your in-store purchase when you buy any travel service. Plus, travel-size Purell hand sanitizer is just 49 cents. Get all set to jet at Staples. Offers end 4/22. In-store only. Exclusions apply.
It's 53 after the hour. Time now for your next job.
Of all the steps in the hiring process, one of the most frustrating is the initial phone screen. Many candidates seem to resent it. They want to meet the employer in person. But companies often view it as a valuable screening tool. Here are three tips on how to nail that phone screen interview. First, avoid long-winded answers. Try to be direct and concise. Before you speak for too long, try asking, does that give you what you're looking for? Or would you like me to go into more detail? That's a very important.
529. Mega Millions, 3, 21, 29, 46, 63, Mega Ball, 9, the winner. Let's get another check of our AccuWeather forecast. Early this morning, partly to mostly cloudy, chilly, a low of 40. Later today, look for cloudiness, breezy, and much chillier conditions with a shower or two. Some wet snowflakes are possible, a low of high of 48. And tonight, some clouds, chilly, a low of 35. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy, brisk and chilly, going up to 48 degrees again. And Monday, intervals of clouds and sun, a high of 55. And Tuesday, a little bit warmer, mostly cloudy and still cool, 53 will be the high. And Wednesday, sun, some clouds, and a cool breeze, 53 again on Wednesday. It's 59 after the hour.
Featuring the news that matters and breaking news at any time. This is Chicago's news traffic and weather station, News Radio.
WBBM, the U.S. Supreme Court has preserved a woman's right to access a medication used in the most common method of abortion, rejecting a lower court ban. CBS News will have the latest. A heavy police presence downtown after an unruly mob took over the Loop last weekend. And
this is Terry Keschner. It has happened again, a case of Legionnaire's disease at the Illinois Veterans Home in Quincy.
WBBM Sports, the Cubs hammer the Dodgers 13-0 at Wrigley. And the Sox blow a ninth-inning lead, falling to the Rays 8-7 in Tampa. CBS News is next at the top of the hour.
This is CBS News on the Hour, presented by Indeed.com.
Our top voter in Washington, likely for months, if not longer, the abortion bill ordered blocked by a Texas federal judge will stay available, pending long appellate court and maybe Supreme Court arguments over the merits of the case against it and the right of its opponents to bring the case.
Abortion rights groups are celebrating the Supreme Court decision. Planned Parenthood Texas calling it good news, but adding that access to mifepristone should have never been in jeopardy in the first place. The case against whether the Food and Drug Administration should have approved the drug over 20 years ago is now headed back to the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals. Anti-abortion rights groups are calling it a temporary setback. Texas Right to Life's John Segoe.
We think that this case will end up in some victory for the pro-life movement. Unfortunately, we're just not seeing any of that effect with today's ruling.
Chris Fox for CBS News, Austin.
Severe weather is causing death, injury, and damage again in parts of the country, and more of that is expected. Correspondent Jim Pursuma.
Strong storms, including confirmed tornadoes, caused damage from Texas to Iowa. At least three people were killed in Oklahoma. Paul Hedrick lost his home in hard-hit cold Oklahoma.
Gosh, yeah, well, that's material things, Yeah, it's material things, but it's still, it's your heart. Your family's working hard for all this.
More severe weather, including the chance of tornadoes, is in the forecast today across the southeast and mid-Atlantic, and next Tuesday in central Texas. Jim Crissel, CBS News.
There's been a major development in the investigation of the fatal movie set shooting in New Mexico involving the film star and producer Alec Baldwin. The criminal charge against him now dropped.
The decision to dismiss the charges comes after prosecutors say new evidence has emerged and they can't go ahead with Alec Baldwin's case. That new evidence reportedly involves modifications made to the gun before the shooting occurred. The modifications may have made it easier for the gun to go off. Meanwhile, the involuntary manslaughter charge against the film's weapons supervisor, Hannah Gutierrez, remains. And prosecutors say Baldwin isn't necessarily off the hook. It's possible charges against him could be refiled. Steve Ullman, CBS News.
And CBS News wires, there has been work on evacuation plans to get U.S. diplomats out of Sudan. Northeast African nations caught in a deadly military dispute involving two rival generals and their followers. Plans, yes, but no decisions yet.
Ultimately, this comes down to a presidential decision. Is he going to decide that the risk to Americans in Khartoum
unlike other warranty companies. We should call now. 800-301-4089.
The last thing we need is an unexpected car repair bill. I'm calling Oxcar Care now.
Call Oxcar Care for your free quote. 800-301-4089. Ask about senior and military discounts. Ox covers commercial car owners too. Don't get stuck with a major car repair bill. Call Oxcar Care. 800-301-4089.
Why do you take in the coronation in London while keepsakes and souvenirs are available and then some?
There are official royal tchotchkes galore for sale ahead of King Charles' coronation, but none has come close to the popularity of Queen Elizabeth's Jubilee Barbie. It was out of stock in 3 seconds last summer. There's still some time for her son's memorabilia to catch up. Britain's Center for Retail Research estimates the May 6th coronation will boost consumer spending there by the equivalent of $1.7 million, thanks to biscuit tins, tea towels, teddy bears, and such, with Charles and Camilla's names and likenesses for sale. Deborah Rodriguez, CBS News.
Plenty of confusion to go around about legitimate accounts on Twitter, which this week stripped some famous people of their blue check marks of validity, among them Beyonce, Pope Francis, Oprah Winfrey, former President Trump. I'm Tom Foti, CBS News.
Chicago's News Traffic and Weather Station, News Radio 105.9 and WBBM NewsRadio.com.
It's 5 after the hour, Saturday, April 22nd. Good morning, I'm Erin Black, and thanks for joining us. Early this morning, look for partly to mostly cloudy, chilly conditions, a lower 40. Later today, considerable cloudiness, breezy, much chillier, with a shower or two. Some wet snowflakes are possible, a high of 48. The complete AccuWeather forecast coming up in a few minutes. But first, our top local story on News Radio WBBM. The violence and chaos downtown in Chicago last weekend has prompted one Chicago alderman to voice his concerns and offer ideas for solutions.
Alderman Brian Hopkins represents the Second Ward, which includes Streeterville and the Gold Coast. And he says there's a ripple effect of damage from the downtown violence, especially given how much was caught on video and shared on social media for the world to see.
It's an embarrassing situation to have Chicago be discussed in these terms of preventive business.
As for how the city can fix it, Hopkins suggests better planning and training.
It's not something that a typical police officer has experienced. You're a police officer, you're dealing with common situations, and then all of a sudden you find yourself in a mob of 300 violent rioters. That is not something that happens every day. So you have to practice, you have to train for it, you have to conduct drills, you have to simulate it in the police training academy. All these things need to occur so that when these situations pop up,
Mai Martinez, 105.9 WBBM. A man is dead after being shot by police in the south suburbs yesterday morning. WBBM's Carolina Garibay reports. Dalton police say they were responding to a call from a woman regarding some type of disturbance involving a man she had an order of protection against. Two officers say they saw a man in a car holding a weapon when they arrived. After several efforts to get him to drop that weapon, the officers reportedly opened fire, killing the man. This happened on 144th Place, just east of MLK Drive in Dalton. Illinois State Police are investigating. Carolina Garibay, 105.9 WBBM.
There's another case of Legionnaires' disease at the Illinois Veterans Home in downstate Quincy.
Since 2015, at least 14 veterans at the Illinois Veterans Home in Quincy have died from Legionnaires. More than 60 others have become sick. Now, another case. The Illinois Department of Public Health and the Illinois Department of Veterans say while it's an isolated case, the residents are going to be monitored closely for at least the next 2 weeks. The resident who has Legionnaires now experienced mild symptoms and is said to be recovering well. Legionnaires is a form of pneumonia. It's usually spread by breathing in small droplets of water in the air that contains the bacteria. Terry Keschner, 105.9 WBBM.
A 57-year-old Lake Barrington man will spend about 15 years in prison for the drug-induced homicide of his grandson. The Daily Herald reports Brian K. McKay pleaded guilty Friday, admitting to the death 2 years ago of his 15-year-old grandson in Marseilles, Illinois. Prosecutors say Mulcahy was supervising his grandchildren at a home there in Marseilles when he supplied his grandson with alcohol, marijuana, and heroin containing fentanyl, which led to his overdose, and also supplied his grandson with the straw he used to inhale the heroin. The teen died in his bedroom. U.S. Senator Dick Durbin yesterday announced $500,000 in federal funding to expand youth mentorship opportunities.
opportunities they can provide to youth on the south and west sides of the city. In the West Loop, Brandon Eisen, 105.9 WBBM.
A reminder, when you want to listen to WBBM on your phone, download the free Odyssey app and put the word follow for easy access. Or when you're home, just ask your smart speaker to play WBBM News Radio. Let's get a first check this hour of our forecast. The AccuWeather forecast says early this morning, partly to mostly cloudy, chilly, a low of 40. And later today, considerable cloudiness, breezy, much chillier with a shower or two. Some wet snowflakes are possible. High of 48. And tonight, some clouds and chilly, a low of 35. And tomorrow, mostly cloudy, brisk, about the same. Going up to 48 degrees. And Monday, a little bit warmer. Intervals of clouds and sun, a high of 55. It's 10 after the hour.
Got the edge for a sports car, exotic or luxury pre-owned vehicle? Put you luxury imports will smash that edge. Over 900 pre-owned vehicles are in stock waiting for you. Convertibles, high performance models, exotics, all with low interest rates. Smash your edge at put you luxury imports or at GLIGoodview.com.
Champagne's not as cheap as ginger ale, and you can't buy caviar for the same price as candy. But now, you can buy Beautyrest Hybrid in the highest end Tempur-Pedic mattresses for nowhere near highest end prices. Hassleless Mattress is clearing out a handful of premium floor models, like the Beautyrest Queen Haven Bay was on sale for $1,178, now just $471. Only a few remain, and they will sell out. Find an employee-free Chicagoland showroom near you at Hassleless.com.
Cubs fans, baseball is back.
It's a home run.
Catch every pitch from every Chicago Cubs game live with 670 The Score on the free Odyssey app.
Can't believe it, did he make the catch? Yes, he did.
The voices you know, the team you love.
Deep drive to left center back corner. It's got a chance. Oh!
Your Chicago Cubs, your Odyssey. Download the free Odyssey app today.
It's 11 after the hour. Parents who want full-day kindergarten for their children may not have to wait much longer. WBBM's Nancy Hardy reports a proposal to require Illinois school districts offer it is moving through the legislature. About 700 school districts already offer full-day kindergarten. A bill before the state Senate, 852, do so in 4 years. Chalk Beach, Chicago cites a study by the National Center for Education Statistics that found students in full-day had better reading and math comprehension, as well as social and emotional skills. A new site reports River Forest District 90 is moving to full-day after COVID made clear the different resources for low and high-income families. The Illinois Association of School Board Administrators is among those that support the idea, but have concerns about additional costs, space, and teachers needed to make it happen. Nancy Hardy, 105.9 WBBM. Organ and tissue donors and their families were honored at an event in the western suburbs yesterday. Dozens gathered to light candles and watch the raising of the Gift of Hope flag. Dr. Julie Fitzgerald is co-chair of the Organ and Tissue Donation Committee at the Loyola Medical Center in Maywood, where the ceremony was held.
We feel it's really important to recognize all the work that goes into a and that starts at the very beginning with our donor families and the decisions that they have to make regarding donation, and then the process of including Gift of Hope, finding the perfect recipient for each of those organs.
April is Donate Life Month. As of December 2021, more than 100,000 people in the U.S. are on a waiting list for a life-saving organ, including nearly 4,000 here in Illinois. Prison and environmental advocates say the state's prison water is still unfit to drink. In the year since the Illinois Department of Public Health notified the Department of Corrections of Legionella bacteria in several of the prison's water, several more violations have been identified. They gathered outside the state building yesterday, calling on Governor Pritzker to fix the problem. Attorney Alan Mills with the Uptown People's Law Center says the state should get more people out of harm's way and just release some inmates.
There are old people there, there are disabled people there, there are people suffering from advanced dementia who don't even know that they're drinking poison water. There's no reason they should be in prison. Let them go. Reduce our prison population. It's the only way out of it. The Department of Corrections has said 50 years ago, we're not going to build our way out of this problem.
Advocates also say if the
Have you been dreaming about new window treatments for your home? Well, now you can stop dreaming and start dialing. On the phone and dial 773 Classic for your free in-home estimate. You'll save up to 50% off retail with no interest payments for up to 2 years. You do know it's best to choose your drapes where you use your drapes. At Classic Draperies, we give your windows the treatment they deserve. Now remember, drapery and blind shop at home, just pick up that phone and dial 773 Classic today. That's 773 Classic. And if you're looking to purchase new drapes and blinds for your home, but you don't know who to call, well, not even call Classic Draperies. Simply pick up the phone and dial 773 Classic for your free in-home estimate. You can choose from decorative drapes for your living room, romantic Roman shades for the bedroom, or solar shades for your sunroom. Dial 773 Classic now and save up to 50% off retail, plus up to 2 years of free financing. Now remember, for drapery shop at home, just pick up that phone and dial 773 Classic today. Call now.
It's 15 after the hour. Time now for the AccuWeather 5-day forecast, sponsored by Four Seasons Heating, Air Conditioning, Plumbing, and Electric. Here's meteorologist Carl Babinski.
Early on this Saturday morning, partly to mostly cloudy and chilly, low 40. Later today, considerable cloudiness, breezy, and much chillier with a shower or two. There could even be some wet snowflakes, high 48. Partly cloudy tonight, low 35. Mostly cloudy, brisk, and remaining chilly tomorrow, high 48. Monday, with intervals of clouds and sunshine, the high 55. Tuesday, mostly cloudy, remaining cool, high 53. Wednesday, sunshine, patchy clouds, and a cool breeze, high 53. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Carl Babinski.
16 after the hour, time now for WBBM Sports. The White Sox blew a late lead in Tampa, falling to the Rays 8-7. And Sox reliever Ronaldo Lopez gave up a pair of ninth-inning home runs, including a two-run walk-off to Brandon Lowe. A much different story on the north side. Judson Richards has that story and the rest of the day in sports.
We'll begin the friendly confines. Cup starter Drew Smyly took a perfect game into the eighth inning, but an infield hit by the Dodgers, David Peralta, allowed him to reach base. So no perfect game for Smyly, but a stellar outing nonetheless, allowing just one hit over 7 2/3 innings, striking out 10. Smyly becomes the first Cubs pitcher to be perfect for 7 innings since Jose Guzman back in 1993. As an organization, the Cubs are still looking for their first perfect game. Now, Smyly didn't necessarily need a ton of run support, but boy, did he get it, including one of the hottest hitters in all of baseball, Patrick Wisdom, now in the fifth.
Wisdom sets up high, kicks, and delivers. High drive into deep left field. Down the line, if it's there, it's gone, and this one is long gone. Cubs have blown the doors open. A three-run home run by Patrick Wisdom. 8-0 Cubs over the Dodgers here in the fifth.
Sexton on the call, 670 to score. That's Wisdom's ninth of the year, tied for most in baseball at game's end. Cody Bellinger, Trey Mancini, Nico Horner also homered. One of four hits for Horner. Cubs blast the Dodgers 13-0. It's the most lopsided loss the Dodgers have ever suffered at Wrigley. Cubs have scored 10 runs or more in six of their first 19 games. Now to football, four Lions players were among five players league-wide to be suspended for violating the NFL's gambling policy. Lions wide receiver Quintez Cephas and safety C.J. Moore and Washington Commanders defensive end Sean Pantoni have been suspended indefinitely. Lions former first-round pick Jamison Williams, the wide receiver, and Stanley Berryhill are being suspended for six games each for mobile betting that occurred at the Lions facility. These two did not bet on NFL games. The Lions have since released Cephas and Moore. The sports at 16 and 46, Judson Richards, News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
It's 18 after the hour. Time now for traffic and weather together. Here's Jennifer Thompson with our overnight road projects.
At the junction in the left lane and on the inbound Kennedy in the two left lanes from Montrose to Ohio until late November. After 10 p.m. tonight, shuttle buses will replace weakened CTA Blue Line service between Addison and Western to accommodate work replacing the 50-year-old track. Extra time is needed. The outbound Kennedy, Fullerton Avenue to Addison, the two left lanes are closed until 8 a.m. I-55 Will County southbound before U.S. 52. From Route 59, the two left lanes until 9 a.m. Inbound I-57 Moni Manhattan Road to Stumble, the right lane is closed until 10 p.m. to 8 a.m. along with various ramps. Outbound 119th to 127th, the two right lanes until 7 a.m. Northbound 394 before is spot between 95th and 2-9. Jane Addams westbound, work is planned between Roselle and Route 31 and Marion Lane overnight, 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. I-80 westbound before Richardson Pass Center, the two right lanes are closed Friday, 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. on Monday, with various ramps closed through the work zone. Both sides, I-55 and Ridge, the left lane is blocked 8 p.m. to 10 a.m. You get traffic and weather together on News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
AccuWeb says early this morning, partly to mostly cloudy, chilly, a low of 40, and later today, you'll need your coat. It's going to be considerable cloudiness, breezy, with much chillier, with a snow shower possible. And tonight, some clouds, chilly, a low of 35 degrees. Tomorrow, about the same, mostly cloudy, high of 48. And Monday, intervals of clouds and sun going up to about 55, a little bit warmer. And Tuesday, mostly cloudy, still cool, a high of 53. Wednesday, some clouds and a cool breeze, a high of 53 also. It's 20 after the hour. Our top story is the abortion pill, Mifepristone, remains available, according to a decision by the Supreme Court, and will likely stay that way until at least next year. We'll have much more on the story coming up at 31 after the hour. Not everyone in the cannabis business is hitting the jackpot. Craft growers say they have millions tied up in licenses, which have yet to generate money. Other growers blame aggressive regulations. Illinois Independent Craft Growers Association says state leaders need to think about social equity license holders. She says operators who are investing their livelihood into this market that has yet to become operational for them. One grower at a Capital News conference said a business which required $5 to $10 million investment at the beginning has a license which today would sell for just $1 million. Scott Redman, president of the Illinois Independent Craft Growers Association, says he and others like him have a lot to lose.
$1 million sounds like a lot of money. It is a lot of money. But these facilities cost anywhere between $5 and $10 million to construct. There are a lot of requirements that are very expensive. We need to have over 100 security cameras. We need to have redundancy. We need to have generators. The HVAC is easily $500,000 or more.
Six Flags Great America's 2023 season starts today. Six Flags spokesperson Rachel Kinziora says instead of new roller coasters this year, the focus has been on enhancing the overall guest experience by adding new events.
While that could mean adding a new ride or a new attraction, I think it also means adding completely new experiences for our guests. And this year, our focus is really providing that elevated special event and festival experience for our guests.
And coming up in Bloomberg Business, Nike's jog into cutting-edge territory. It's 22 after the hour.
To be able to breathe properly when you sleep is a profound change. To be able to
unlock access to physical items or make them available in video games. There, Andrew Lee says, is the rub.
There isn't one metaverse yet, so the reality is that these sneakers probably won't work on many, if not most, of the metaverse implementations.
The Metaverse Insider says Nike's metaverse consists of the new Dot Swoosh platform and Nike Land, which is a fully realized virtual world where you can customize your avatar and connect with others. Roblox says it's gotten more than 31 million visits, but Andrew Lee says he's thinking a little early to expect too much more.
Nike may be ready for the metaverse, but the metaverse isn't ready for Nike.
With business at 23 and 53, from the Bloomberg Newsroom, Joe Doniger, News Radio 105.9 WBBM.
And speaking of the metaverse, questions are being asked about the future, which has seemingly cooled off in recent months. Michael Wolff, founder and CEO of Activate Consulting and former president of MTV in New York, joins Rob Hart on the WBBM New Business Hour to explain why the metaverse is not dead, but actually inevitable.
The metaverse, or Web 3, or augmented reality, whatever you want to call it, it seems to be going through a bit of bad press lately, and a lot of it is tied up in the fact that Facebook really hitched their wagon to it and renamed the company and rebranded it, and they're having a really hard time with it. But setting Mark Zuckerberg aside, what is the state of the metaverse or augmented reality these days?
Somehow everybody believes that all of the companies are going to turn their attention away from metaverse to AI, and that let's not worry about the metaverse. In a lot of ways, the metaverse now matters more than ever. I mean, one of the reasons is it's not a question of is it AI versus metaverse. It's not an either or, it's the two together. So AI will significantly expand the user base, but also you've got metaverse features that will now be easy. You now have it so that people can actually create their own metaverse. They can create the avatar that they want to have, and in a way that you now have hundreds of millions of developers in the metaverse.
And it seems like what we're calling the metaverse or augmented reality is the melding of a number of disciplines that we have all been living with for quite some time, whether it was someone who had a Second Life avatar way back when, someone who was in The Sims, someone who was playing there, has an online persona on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, and that's all of us. We don't put everything online. We just put on the best version of ourselves, or what we think is the best version of ourselves. So we're playing in that space to begin with, and that it seems like the influencers and the Bored Apes and the people who were touting the metaverse about a year and a half ago kind of confused the discussion of where it's going.
Well, you're right that they confused the discussion because they somehow equated metaverse with VR and AR. And so here's the numbers. You have between Roblox, Minecraft, and Fortnite, and World of Warcraft, you have 300 million people who are spending a great deal of their lives in a major virtual world metaverse game. We forecast by 2025 there's going to be 750 million people in those environments. How can you view this as, how can you ignore this, and how can you view it's not going to happen?
Michael Wolff, founder and CEO of Activate Consulting, former president of MTV based in New York.
A reminder, you can catch the Noon Business Hour each weekday and subscribe to the podcast at odyssey.com or wherever you get your podcasts. Let's get a quick check of our AccuWeather forecast. Early this morning, partly to mostly cloudy, chilly, a low of 40 degrees. And later today, look for breezy, chillier conditions with a shower or two. Some wet snowflakes are possible, a high of 48 degrees only. And tonight, some clouds and chilly, a low of 35. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy, brisk and chilly again. For Sunday, a high of 48 degrees. News headlines up next. It's 29 after the hour.
The EPA reports the air we breathe in our home is more polluted than the air outside. The healthy solution? Green Tea Services Air Duct Cleaning.
Service to us.
Hi, this is Tonya Khoury, owner of Green Tea Services. Our Green Tea air duct purification system thoroughly cleans all your intakes, returns, and furnace. You'll breathe fresh, healthier air.
top stories on News Radio WBBM. The Supreme Court rules to allow a commonly used abortion pill to remain on the market while the case makes its way through the lower courts.
This is Nancy Hardy. It could be a reason to raise a pint. 168 years ago, the Bob Revere riot saw immigrants clash with Chicago police over attempts to outlaw drinking on Sunday.
A woman is again charged in the attack of a student at Indiana University. Man?
This is Brandon Ice, and the GoFundMe is now raising money for a local early childhood teacher seriously injured in a hit and run.
WBBM Sports, the Cubs hammer the Dodgers 13-0 at Wrigley, and the Sox blow a ninth-inning lead, falling to the Rays 8-7 in Tampa. AccuWeather says later today, look for breezy conditions, cool. Some wet snowflakes are possible, going up to only 48 degrees. And tonight, some clouds, chilly, a low of 35. At 31 after the hour, the Supreme Court has reserved women's access to a drug used in the most common method of abortion, rejecting lower court restrictions while a lawsuit continues. The justices yesterday granted emergency requests from the Biden administration and the maker of the drug, Mifepristone. They're appealing a lower court ruling that would hold back FDA approval of Mifepristone. At an anti-abortion protest outside the Supreme Court, Reverend Patrick Mahoney of the Stanton Public Policy Center spoke about yesterday's decision.
I cannot overstate how critical this case is. In some ways, it's almost more critical than Dobbs, because it will reveal what this court will think for future decisions that come before them.
Mifepristone has been used in the U.S. since 2000, and more than 5 million women have used it. The streets of downtown Chicago were full of angry residents 168 years ago yesterday in what became known as the Lagerbier riot. WBBM's Nancy Dayton reports. Nancy Hardy reports.
Outraged by the city raising the liquor license fee for taverns and saloons from $50 to $300, historian and author Richard Lindbergh says German and Irish immigrants protested outside Chicago's courthouse.
They were carrying bowling pieces, which was a kind of a blunderbuss of a gun. Truncheons, hammers, meat cleavers, and all kinds of food-holding weapons.
He says one police officer died in a riot that pitted newcomers against nativist Mayor Levi Boone and his Know Nothing Party, a dynamic Lindbergh says has not gone away.
We're seeing it today with opposition to immigration along the southern border. It's just a variation of a very old story.
He's writing a new book which discusses more of Chicago's history with liquor and vice districts that's slated for publication next year. Nancy Hardy, 105.9 WBBM.
Police have announced an Indiana woman has been charged again for attacking a student earlier this year. WBBM's Carolina Garibay reports.
Prosecutors say in January, 56-year-old Billy Davis stabbed an 18-year-old Indiana University student in the head on a public bus. Davis had already been charged with attempted murder and aggravated battery, but officials say she's now also been charged with a federal hate crime. According to court documents, Davis says she stabbed the student, who is of Chinese descent, because of her race. Police say the student, who has not been publicly identified, survived the attack. Carolina Garibay, 105.9 WBBM.
About $10,000 has now been raised through a GoFundMe for an early childhood education teacher seriously injured in a hit-and-run earlier this month. WBBM's Brandon Eisen has the story.
Fanara Hanal was hit by a car April 4th as she walked to her job as an assistant teacher at the Kids Academy Early Childhood Development Center in Jefferson Park. Broken bones and head trauma after several surgeries. Hanal is still in the hospital recovering, and doctors say it could be months before she can return to work. It's all according to a coworker who set up the GoFundMe for Hanal with the goal of raising $25,000 for medical bills. All donations will go directly to Fanara Hanal's checking account. Link can be found on the WBBM website. Brandon Eisen, 105.9 WBBM.
Michigan State University says it will not be cooperating with a request from Michigan's Attorney General seeking additional documents pertaining to the case of former gymnastics doctor Larry Nassar. WWJ's John Hewitt has more.
The request from Attorney General David Nassar sought the release of some 6,000 documents pertaining to Larry Nassar that Michigan State University had previously withheld. At Friday's Board of Trustees meeting, Chair Reba Vassar said the university will not comply with this latest request.
And she is general counsel for the AG's office that we will not take any new action. Therefore, we will be doing a attorney-client privilege. On behalf of the board, please know we are sorry.
Fellow trustee Dennis Donner.
Stolen in a high street.
not able to confirm the cargo's final destination, nor if the theft was related to organized crime or professional thieves. We also weren't sure if the gold is still in Canada. Still to come, top trending stories, sports, overnight boat projects, and weather. It's 42 after the hour.
It's time. Time to empty your closets, junk drawers, and garage of all your old, unused tech. It's time to bag those batteries that bit the dust. Time to tell that old calculator its days are numbered. Time to tell your old hard drive a hard truth. It's time to go. It's time to recycle it all at Staples for free. Plus, this weekend, you save 15% on your purchase of $30 at Staples when you recycle that tech junk for Earth Day. Offer valid 422 and 423. Limit one reward per month. Exclusions apply. Visit staples.com/recycling for details.
Spring Black Friday at the Home Depot. We have laundry appliances that just fit your space, fit your needs, and fit your budget. Like a new Samsung laundry set with large capacity, so you spend less time doing laundry. And sensor dry technology to automatically optimize time and temperature.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Thanks for the likes and the subs. This is a pretty good exercise in perspective. You can kind of tell that that alley is running away from us. And that we're closer to one side of the alleyway than the other. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for the likes and the subs.